Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video, I will show you how to categorize the ComboBox pop-up list items using the grouping feature and its template. I will also show you how to filter the ComboBox list items. Let's get right to the coding part. I will open my existing application, which already has the Syncfusion React dropdowns package installed. On the app.tsx page, I have included the basic ComboBox rendering code. If you need to know how to create a basic React ComboBox component, you can refer to my Getting Started video link in the card above and in the description below. With this code, you can visualize the employee list. Let's take a quick look at the data I have bound to the data source property of the ComboBox component. Let me run this application and show you the output. Look at the ComboBox component. When I click the drop-down icon, an employee list is displayed. First, I'll show you how to categorize the ComboBox list items using the Group By property. In the field settings, I add the Group By property and set its value to designation. Look at the ComboBox now. List items are categorized based on the designation. Now, I will show you how to customize the ComboBox list group header using Group Template property. I just defined the constant method custom group header and access the designation from the props variable. I also add the class name custom group to the wrapper element. I open the app.css page and define the styles like color and font for the custom group class. Assign this method to the group template property of the ComboBox component. See now, when I open the pop-up, the list displays the customized group header. Next, I will show you how to filter data items. I enable the Allow Filtering property. See, when you start typing the characters, items will be filtered based on that. By default, combo box items are filtered ignoring case. To filter the items with case sensitivity, add ignore case property and set its value to false. Now you can see list items are filtered based on case. Let's see the different filter types available in ComboBox. The default filter type is starts with. Other types are contains and ends with. I include the filter type property and set its value to ends with. Now the items are filtered based on the last character. When you change the filter type to contains, items are filtered based on the characters in the word typed. ComboBox also supports diacritic filtering. I changed the filter type to starts with to demonstrate this with simple example. To enable this support, I add the ignore accent property and set its value to true. In the data.js file, let me add a few diacritic characters on the items. Check now, when I start typing a word, diacritic characters will be filtered. Let me recap what we have seen so far. I showed you how to categorize the ComboBox pop-up list items using the grouping feature and its template, and how to filter data items. You can download a working example from the GitHub link in the description for this video below. I've also provided a link where you can see if you're eligible for our community license, which will provide you with a free license key to use our products. Thank you for watching this video. If you found this video useful, give it a like and subscribe to our channel.